attention, and we're just about set to kick off. It's time for the coin toss now, presented by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. Auburn lines up to kick this one off, and we're just about set to get underway. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down to the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Five wide. He steps out around the 27-yard line. He goes out of bounds at the 29-yard line. He's tackled at about the 37-yard line. On third and long, they get the first down, but was it close?
Close or not, what a relief it is to the quarterback to have a new set of downs to work with.
He gets out to about the 38-yard line. Tackle at the 47. Makes the catch, and look out, he's pushed out of bounds at about the 49. Second and six coming up here. Ball on the 49. He's got an opening. Nice gain as he works the right side.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their schemes.
Down, and he's going to get sacked.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. I'd be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Quick throw. He's taken down at the 36. Another run. Runs outside for a nice gain. Third down has been the charm on this drive.
Yeah, it's been all about execution. When it comes to calling the right play at the right time, they've been able to do it here.
And they make the stop at the 21.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it 2nd and 2.
They'll bring him down at the 25. And this is the 13th play of this drive. Fires it out. He gets hit out of bounds.
Right around the 22-yard line.
They get 3 yards on the play.
This young wide receiver has the raw ability to make some big plays. So that was a good job there by the defense to stop him for a short game.
North Carolina State could take the lead with this field goal. And it sails through the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. Down at the 24. The Tigers know that they can give this guy the ball, Kirk, 25, 30 times a game, and that's great. And if it's working, that's perfect. But also, as a defensive team, you look at him and you go, we worry about him too much, we could get burned somewhere else.
Well, the defensive coaches told us this week the first thing that they have to do is stop this running game. And when you're convinced that you have to stop the running game, you leave your defensive backs, especially your corners, isolated one-on-one in coverage. And if they're smart, they'll try to take advantage of that and try to make some big plays in the passing game, maybe early, and then go back to old reliable, and that's running the football.
Tackle made at the 35. First, and he's tackled around the 47-yard line.
Man, did he ever sell the run? The defense took the bait, and that hesitation was enough to give the receiver room to make the catch.
36. And down he goes around the 48-yard line. With room to work, brought down at the 43.
Greatest pass, but a really, really good play by the receiver to bail out his quarterback.
That makes a first and 10.
From the 19-yard line, first down. And they got him for a loss. This is the eighth play of this drive. Quick pass, tight end, and he wasn't ready for it. They'll line it up again on third down. And a quick throw. And they push him out around the 9-yard line. He'll get it again. He gets out to about the 9-yard line. Touchdown, Tigers. And he converts the extra point. An 11-play, 75-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their minds. They just need to go out there and play. Makes it to the 34.
That's a deep nine. That brings in second and nine.
Nice run there. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. There are three quarters remaining. Auburn up by four. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Going right to his tailback. He's tackled at the 45-yard line.
Number 12 on the tackle at the 45-yard line.
So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. And he's level at the 44.
Number 15 makes the tackle at the 44-yard line.
From the 44-yard line. First down. At the 31-yard line. He's into the open field.
Gaining 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
Complete. He's got room. And he is drilled at the 12.
Number 14 with the tackle at the 4-yard line. First down.
Strike to his receiver. No good.
I mean, he has his wide receiver wide open. You spend all those hours during the week to be able to get prepped and ready to go. You got an open man like this, just step and deliver and make the throw.
He tackles him for a loss. Quickly incomplete.
Wasn't a bad pass at all, but just a good heads-up effort to get his fingertips on the ball.
This should be an easy field goal. Irby, this guy headed to the locker room a little bit earlier with that injury. We don't know how bad it is, but right now it doesn't look like he's likely to play any more football. The kick is up, and it's good. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Auburn with a one-point lead. Draw play. He gets to about the 34-yard line. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. There's a strike complete. Has some daylight. He's taken down around the 44-yard line. Makes it out to about the 29. His way to the 19-yard line.
It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. And they make the stop around the 11-yard line. Auburn is up one. Outside after a nice pickup. They get 4 yards on the halfback option. This is the ninth play of this drive. The Tigers will use their first time out of the half. Makes the PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
Gains his way to the 36-yard line. Little draw play. He makes it to the 38-yard line.
At this point, boys, you're playing against the defense and the clock, so you might want to consider to hurry things up.
Second and 8. Ball on the 38. Passes back across his body, but nobody there.
Number 26, the intended receiver on the play.
Third down.
Catches it, and that's all. That pass play went for nearly enough to keep moving, but they're stopped just short. Boy, that's tough.
That is always a tough pill to swallow. Having to leave the field, knowing how close you came to converting on third down. You got to get those.
Booming kick. So this one goes into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. The Tigers have had so much success here in the first half. Kirk, you got to look really in the third and fourth quarter. If they get just maybe a little bit too complacent, start playing not to lose instead of to win.
Yeah, they got to keep their foot on the accelerator. They're off to such a great start. I mean, this is exactly the way they had hoped this game would unfold, and it is. But it's a four-quarter game, and if they start to, as you say, get complacent, it's give this their opposing team a chance to come back and win this football game. This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days. This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
He's got it with room to run. That's a great tackle at the 47-yard line. Auburn holds an 8-point advantage. Going long. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
You like a team that's ready to defend the pass. It takes some preparation to get in the way of a pass like that.
A minute left in the half. Quickly, and it's almost intercepted.
Brady drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. They'll bring him down at the 44-yard line.
That's a deep. That brings us a working
try to change the field position with his kick. Was a nice little pooch kick right there.
That's why they made the decision to punt the ball right there. They wanted to pin this offense deep in their own territory. This team really trusts their defense.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Got the corner. And they get nice yardage on that run. We've played a half of football here. Auburn's up by 8.
Glad to have you with us in the studio for the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Reese Davis and David Pollack here completely locked in on that first half. Both of these defenses are opportunistic and very good at forcing turnovers. But both quarterbacks, David, have done a very good job while trying to maintain an aggressive mindset. They haven't forced the ball. The runners have done a good job keeping it put away.
Yeah, and as much as you preach that all throughout the week, it's still hard to do. It's hard to execute. And being able to see what you see on the defensive side of the football and adjust to it offensively, how about protecting the quarterback so he's not getting hit from the blind side, fumbling the football, ball carriers running with the football, keeping it tight to their body, not giving it away. So, you know, between running backs, receivers, and quarterbacks, offensive linemen blocking, did a great job executing on the offensive side of the football, not to give away any turnovers.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 23. The quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Auburn is up by 8. Here's a handoff left side. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. He's got his halfback. He's pushed out of bounds at the 23-yard line. Slings it. Tackle made right around the 44-yard line. It to the 44. Fires it out, and he's tackled around the 40-yard line. So we're looking at another third down here.
Man left.
Auburn up by 8. Complete across the middle, and he tackles him hard at the 28-yard line.
Number 7 makes the tackle at the 28-yard line. First down.
after positive yardage. Fires a laser touchdown. For the wideout.
Yeah, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And he hits the PAT. To kick this one away. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Tigers continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. They'll line up with five wide receivers. He steps out at the 28. In the shotgun and five wideouts. And he's taken down around the 36-yard line. Complete, he's hit right away. They come out in a five wide set. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly. It out to him again. Brought down around the 47-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
They come out on an empty backfield. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked. Second and 10. Ball on their own 47. Scrambling around. Slides down to the ground. Caught, open field, and he hits him hard at the 30-yard line. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He's tackled at the 10. Everybody was fooled on that one.
Hey, that was a good job here by the quarterback. That could have play fake as a real weapon against an aggressive defense like this.
Q26. Mike 5.
There was some movement on the line.
False start.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they can just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
So the penalty will make it first and 15. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. The tailback picks up a solid 7 yards on the counter play. Down he goes at the 2-yard line. He's in for the score. catch it as the quarterback's able to run it in.
I'll tell you what, when you're a quarterback and the goal line is right there, it's pretty hard to pitch the ball when you think you can get in. That's a smart decision to keep it for the score.
And he converts the extra point. So a 12-play, 78-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. So our score, 21-13. North Carolina State gets set to kick this one away. He's to the 20, and he's tackled at the 26. They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
So it's second and 10, ball on the 26. Auburn holds an 8-point advantage. Short pass, middle of the field. Tackle right around the 32-yard line. The defensive lineman that got a hold of him there.
You're not going to break many tackles when this guy gets his hands on you.
And this one is a beauty. Brought down to the 38-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. Makes it out to about the 50. He's got the corner. He's at the 40. Knocked out of bounds around the 39-yard line. So with one quarter remaining, Auburn in front, 21-13. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. And he is drilled at the 36.
That'll make it second and seven.
It's second and seven. Ball on the 36-yard line. He's taken down right around the 28-yard line.
That's good for a game of 8 yards.
That's right.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. And they push him out around the 12-yard line.
That's a gain of 16. That makes it first and 10.
That's right, man. They don't want it.
They'll spread the field with five wide. And they make the stop around the 3-yard line. And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. Touchdown, Wolfpack.
Oh,
For some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there. But now that they have a lot of momentum here after this score, it's very important that they keep this thing riding and pick up the two-point conversion to tie this game up.
And they get the two.
Two fantastic plays in a row. First the touchdown, and now the conversion. What a turn of events this late in the game.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. He makes his way to about the 38. Level at the 46. Makes it to the 41. There.
Number 18, the intended receiver on the play.
From the 41-yard line. Second down. Up the middle for a nice gain. Just under three to go in regulation. Bring him down around the 23-yard line. He gets rid of this one. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 23-yard line. Completely stopped immediately.
That's a gain of seven. That makes us third and three.
Complete. He's got room. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score. Splits the uprights with the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Taken from the 3-yard line. Oh, man, he took him down hard. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter. Quick throw out to the receiver. Tackle made at about the 37-yard line.
Number 14 makes the tackle at the 37-yard line. That makes it second and two.
Quick out to his receiver. And he's tackled at the 41-yard line.
Delta.
quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 41. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. He chucks it downfield. And he makes the catch. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him with a first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
End zone touchdown. Here's the PAT to tie this thing up. They didn't snap the ball in time.
Delay of game. Offense.
Just over a minute left. And he tacks on the extra point. North Carolina State lines up for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer, and that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown, the other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Gets rid of it. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. Third down now, and they need to get it to the 25. Makes the PAT. this one away. He'll return it from the one. He's taken down at the 36-yard line.
Man, hang on to your hats, folks, because both these offenses are in gear right now.
Well, the way these guys are executing right now, it could come down to just which defense can come up with one stop.
Even in a game this close, I think it's going to take something very unexpected to change the outcome. But that doesn't mean it won't happen. Under a minute left in the game. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And he's taken down at the 41. And they get 5 yards from that completion.
Here's a safe play hitting the underneath receiver, but it's a nice gain of 5.
And that just might do it. Intercepted. Brought down at the 47-yard line. He steps up and makes a big turnover.
Yeah, he just made a huge play right there. He knew what was coming all along.
From the 47-yard line, first down. And he's tackled after positive yardage. NC State's going to have to use their second time out of the half. He fights forward to about the 40. North Carolina State will take their final timeout. That's a great tackle at the 40. So this one goes final. A hard-fought, close game. Auburn, 35. North Carolina State, 28. That's it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you soon.